Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. You might forgive me. You might want to forgive me. I haven't played this game for about a year, so I might be a little rusty on some of these menus and such. But here we are at the Tower of Neon. From this distance, you can feel the mystical aura of Neon's towers. So this might be the final dungeon in the game, so I'm excited to check it out. Surrounded by ancient mountains, caressed by blinding sunlight, and uncovered in a beautiful, mysterious web of clouds, stands the gigantic tower monastery of Lord Neon, the most influential entity of this world. For long centuries, the tower has taken a major part in forming the planet's history, with its weird, but mostly ingenious inventions and ideas based on the extraordinary knowledge and stimulating power of Lord Neon. Even bionecromancy, one of the most controversial sciences, was born here when the very first bionecron opened his eyes to the light behind these walls. It is also very likely that the mediators of Neon are partially responsible for the unborn's appearance. Everything proves that, so this is the only place where you may hope to find the final solution. Cool. We've got an eye door. That's the eye door we came through. Oh, we're not gonna leave. A bunch of eye doors. Dead end. What the hell is going on here? Everything is so still. You see the regular imperial mark of a landing area on this door. Reactor stabilization controls is quite strange in a monastery. Indeed. This door is very well built and indicates correction facility. That's not where we came in, right? Oh, that's here. No, that's a dead end. I guess this was where we came in. Wait. No, it isn't. Oh, hello? A young, long-haired woman steps in front of you. You do not know when and how she came practically out of the nowhere in her traditional costume of an apprentice priestess of Neon. All in all, she looks somehow disturbingly familiar to you. Then she lets out a cold, distant smile and starts to speak with her strange accent. Sorry, sirs. I did not want to frighten you. His Excellency Archon Monterey sent me to escort you to your quarters. Please follow me, if I may ask you. She opens a hidden door and leads you through different winding corridors. I don't want to go different winding corridors. I want to explore this place. Hi again. Excuse me, I have to leave now, but I will be back shortly. Please make yourself comfortable until I let you know when Archon Monterey is ready to receive you. Oh, and please do not attempt to leave the room if you don't want to get in trouble. Thank you. With these words, she leaves the room. What a strange welcome. I cannot leave this room. Well, how long are we supposed to wait? Can we sleep here? So... okay, we're fully rested. I mean, I don't know if we needed rest or if we were already rested. Where are we now? Are we near the same area? Oh, hello. When you try to leave the room, a group of temple guards block your way. You're very surprised by their appearance. And now it is getting harder to convince yourself that you are not some kind of a prisoner here. The leader of the guard steps forward and says, "Sorry, brothers. We were ordered to keep you inside your room for a while. You must go back now, please." Then they escort you back to the room. Awesome artwork. Well, this is vexing. It's all coming back to me now, these different screens. The pony is now fully rested. We're getting bored in here, man. I'm guessing we're in that area that says it was a incarceration, something like that. Doors are always watching, huh? You gonna put me back in again? As you meet the guards once again, the sudden sense of upcoming danger captures you. Something is very unusual about these fighters. Their voice is full of suppressed impatience as they ask you once again to go back to your room and wait. Why don't they lock the door? You just lock? You can't put a lock on a door? My god. Imagine if I'm put in a different cell every time that, like, unknowns to me. Searching is that, like, hidden walls or illusory walls, whatever. I mean, I keep resting. I don't know how long. I don't know if we're supposed to just sit around and wait in real time. Yeah, organism. Well, that sounds different. You're coming out the third time. First, you're wondering why the guards make no. I thought it was him saying that. First, you're wondering why the guards make no effort to stop you. But then a wicked transformation begins as their faces turn into a lifeless dead mask. Then they raise on their feet and scream in a horrible hissing voice, not of their own.
I have just opened my eyes, mortals. You cannot stop me now because I am not blind anymore. Remember, your poor universe is only a creation of your mind. But my universe does exist.
First time during your quest, you feel the real grip of fear. How strong must be the unborn now that it can use its power, even in this place, to set up such a deadly, malevolent trap? At least the unborn doesn't know about locks. I guess... combat. We've got a bunch of these guys, and they're all about to converge on us down in this dead end. Who am I right now? so I'm on Varanus, right? He's fast. Right. He has unlimited speed now. And somehow getting even more unlimited speed. Is this a door? I couldn't, like, open this, could I? That's my personal net station. Oops. Oh, you know what? Wait. I doubt this would work. Unknown command. Nope, all right. Not exactly like open. It's not a nice open area for us to like hide in and stuff. Now, I would stick him over here or something, but he's kind of squishy. So I'm saying out of any of them. He should maybe stay where he is. I forget who these people are. Epsilon. Okay, he's another one. Another squishy fast one. Are we on Catboy? Yeah, Runeclaw. I guess I keep forgetting who is who. Just by the... That's Runeclaw. Yeah, I don't know who these are. That's Epsilon there, right? I think. That's Killdozer. Okay, so... That's Advent. It kind of looks like Deadpool with the staff. temple guard, taking no action. Okay, so we got four of them all preparing for a range attack. Hopefully none of them might throw any grenade kind of things, because we're all bunched up in here. Perception by not doing anything. I'm still on Varanus? Yeah, let's just have him try to attack then. I don't think he can reach any of them now. Definitely not that. I have a feeling not. No, he can't see anyone from here. They have to get into the middle, or he has to move up, either one. I'm defending. Oh, was it too late? What's the battle one? Battle? How do I not? Oh wait, cancel. All right. Told you guys I'm rusty, I'm sorry. So that we're still on him? Oh, we're on Runeclaw now. I'm not gonna see any of them. We're back on Varanus? I thought we were on Runeclaw. Varanus! Defending. A storm of warring something. Missed. Yeah, this is gonna be rough. Varanus. Again. Oh, cool. Oh, I should have hit the middle one. Then I could have got them all three, right? Now this is... Killdozer? Right. Now what is he using? He's using a Gemini plasma laser. Okay. I'm gonna go for that middle one then. Oh, I can't reach. He doesn't have the reach. So you can't see this one either, I'm sure. Just trying, just in case. Well, I'm on Varanus now. That seems to be the hardest thing for me to get used to, is it's switching to different characters. I guess because they're all bunched together. I mean, if they were like spread apart on the map, you'd see it zoom over to where the character was. But we're kind of bunched together. Maybe I should have had the combat ones. His speed. That's insane. Alright, so he is defending. I want him defending right now. And this is Rune Claw, I believe. Yes. You can't reach with that. I'm gonna get him back to stop with the collateral damage a little bit. I'm gonna defend for now. These ones got their brothers in the way. No action. Check our status, vitality. Oh, he's fine. Advent's the one we have to watch out for the most. He's already damaged, and he doesn't have a lot of points. Okay, so with that in mind, I'm gonna just back him up a little. Oh, I didn't mean to do that, I meant to defend. Missed, 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 yay! Yeah, we need to move up a little, don't we? So who is this? I don't want him to get injured. Oh yeah, I'm not looking for that. How do I get... Was it here? I was able to see all their stats. I can't find it now. I forgot! I have forgotten. Well... Maybe I have to cancel for... Well, it shows you here, too. Stamina, vitality. Alright. I tend to not use those, but... I'm just gonna have him defend again. Advent. Right. All Don't think maybe he can see the corner of this guy from where he is, but no. Defend. Actually, cancel. Defend. So this is Killdozer. No, this is Twin Snake. What is he using? A regular shotgun. Okay. That's the guy who got the direct hit last time. Am I still on him? Yeah. Well, at least they miss a lot. Advent again? No, Varanus. Just having to defend until we get some of these people. Some of these enemies are gone. My man. The middle one. Maybe we'll get this guy too, I'm not sure. Oh, we didn't get him. Trying to increase a little speed. Ah! Weapon empty. Well, hopefully we have a... I can reload. Oh. How do I... There was a certain... there's a certain way to reload them. I mean, it could be maybe I don't have any ammo for that. Okay. Not enough action time. Well, I think I have to put the grenade here. Then, yeah, it doesn't look like I have any ammo. Well, that's unfortunate then. Now I'm on Varanus though. They're fighting themselves, partially. Oh, I got a peek at their stats when it goes by. Let me just see who are we working now. And how is this person? Speed is down. Oh boy. Now we want... I don't remember how I got to the stats screen from here. That's the problem. Well, he needs help. And you are? Well, he should start attacking if he can. Let's see. Oh, his weapon is empty as well. Did not know that. I'm not seeing any ammo for him at all. Zero, right? Yeah, we don't have ammo for these. So I want to switch him to the broadsword then, but... Hey, there are no items. Not that. Give me the broadsword. This can go up in here, and give me the broadsword. Did you run behind the enemy? Right? That'd be a good idea. Because one blocks the other. So he has unlimited movement. You can just run back here. And prepare for attack. I'm still having him defend. And then defend. I'm on Varanus again. See, that's confusing. Well, you choose defend, you should only do it once. Defend. Okay, and he's gonna cast this on himself. Awesome. You cast on somebody else. out of curiosity. I can't reach. Oh, okay. So I'm gonna cancel that. What is he using? Oh, he's using the Psy-guided boomerang. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, I'd like to see him use that, so. Even though he's healed, still got bleeding out wounds. That's why I saved his mana. So that character, yeah, even though Epsilon was right behind him, he chose not to take any action. That's funny. Oh, right. Oh, this is how I got to see their values. Just a right click, alright. So, he's gonna throw a grenade. He's got Alpha Catharsis up too. I know it affects vitality and something else. I don't know what the other thing is. It increases. Yeah, we're all right for now. I don't think we need it just yet. Just having him defend. A stab wound. It hurt all of them. Okay. Yeah, he's got all these defends queued up, you can see on top. Literally just in standby mode right now for them, because they're squishy. Nice! First guard death. Missed. Alright, so this is Twin Snake here. Trying to see on the left who has the least vitality so we can take down. Might be this guy. In fact, they're pretty much equal, right? I think. Awesome. Combat efficiency. Gets the Medal of Valor here. Oh, he's got this huge grenade. Dead. Awesome. You have any more of those? Nope. Oh, I've got 7 ammo on this plasma laser. Did it say it was out of ammo? not sure. The weapon's empty. I guess like 7 is like a charge of laser. Maybe that's just not enough. Oh. Not trained to operate that item. That's no good. He's got nothing. He's got nothing. Very unfortunate. Alright. Defend. He can't reach anything. They're very squirrely. They're not coming out to play. Molecular something or other. You're dead. All right, so now he'll run over and repeat it here. His vitality is not that bad, so. Defending. Defending again. He has unlimited speed, right? Yeah. So he's just gonna defend. Defend. Ah. 3 left. Check on vitality. Vitality check. Alright. I guess Advent stopped bleeding out. Gonna complain. Yes, kill Dozer, can't do anything. Defend. Check again. Vitality, because they just all just lost from their bleeding wounds. So I guess he is still bleeding. Yeah, he lost 2 more. I mean, the combat ones, the top 3 here have a lot of vitality to draw from, so. As of before, they could only get hit like 3 times and then they would die, so. It's much better. Varanus, defending. Defend. Defend. Yeah, these enemies are not really moving, so. Let him defend there. Slowly moving up. I don't even know if I can reach this guy. I can. I don't want to expose him to that guy, but... defend. Barbed knife with molecular cutting edge, it says. Defend. Defend. I mean, they're mostly just... to me, they're defensive characters. And we're doing okay, I think. Now that I've said that. 120, 189. Oh wait, I'm looking at the wrong thing. Oh, his stamina's almost out. I think that means he can't move. His stamina's 10. Otherwise, vitality, 29, 49, 41, full, 91, 121. What killdozer? Who was defending? So I think I'll have him... well, he can't reach... yeah, let's just see if we can heal Twin Snake. He needs vitality as well. Getting down there, so... so if I move him here, he'll be hidden from that guy, but he should be able to attack that guy. So if I do a tunnel of life force drain... oh, his stamina's up now. Wait a second. It's his that was low. I thought Epsilon, had low stamina too. I guess, I don't know. Missed. Seven. He fell. He's fallen. Oh, I can't reach him. No. Hold up. His stamina is zero. I think he'll just, like, lay there and then get hit and take bleeding wounds until his vitality goes all the way down and then he dies. But he's just out of range by, like, two squares. Try again, right? Alright, so the life force strain. Oh, he's dead, right? Nice. I mean, it doesn't matter. Really, I want to hide from this other guy because I don't want them both firing on him, so. It's funny, as I move up, it looks like he was moving up with me, but. He's not even going for him. Wait, who's low? I mean, obviously, besides him. Okay, Advent, heal self. Who are we? Are we on Advent? No. Okay, the life force strain. You can already tell he's dead because the vitality disappears. Sweet. Just going around. Getting stuff done here. Where's... Well, he doesn't have that spell selected. We might not have to bring him up, but... Oh, it does affect stamina. Excellent. That's a good spell. He's back up. And ready to kill everyone. And just immediately get the turn to him. Anyone else need some? I mean, we're kind of done here. I can't reach that far. Pretty much safe now. Just in case Varanus needs help. I mean, not Varanus, Epsilon. Does he? Give him some more stamina. I mean, we get all our stuff back, so... as we use the spell points. Too close for a long-range weapon. Better? Get more of that stamina back then. Either has a lot of stamina or it just doesn't get back that much. Maybe a bit of both. Not enough mental energy. Oh, Twin Snake. Oh, could have hit him. I thought that was Killdozer. It's like mano a mano here. What are we using for stuff? What if I hit him, you know, so I'm just gonna defend. Or defend. Done. Battle over. Okay. So we came out of here. Right. Gonna call in an episode here. Well, I'm assuming we're back in this same corridor again. With all the different rooms. I'll try to open them, but... obviously, that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.